This is one of the very important chapter where we'll be discussing boundary conditions, and boundary conditions are primarily the driving factor which directly gives shape your dimension of your problem. And exactly once you specify your correct input conditions so that you can exactly get the required output conditions. So we'll spend much time in understanding this boundary condition protocol, and let us start with the agenda here. And couple of different options are there. I have not highlighted here, but we'll be starting with the defining boundary conditions concept, porous media and other conditions also, and available boundary condition different types in fluent and advanced options we'll be discussing. Let us start with this defining boundary conditions protocol. And if you see this boundary conditions, this is basically defined as the boundary. Boundary means at your boundary or input or output or maybe the internal conditions, everywhere the problem dimension you have to specify. So to define a problem or to get the unique solution, you must specify information on the flow variable at the boundary. This is basically the object here. So you can specify flux of mass, maybe momentum, energy, etc., into the domain. And when you talk about that, I'm defining boundary conditions, that means you have to identify the boundary locations, and also you have to supply the information at those boundaries so that you'll investigate and you'll understand what are the input conditions. The data required also depends at your boundary, the physical model which you have taken, and primarily that also depends on the condition of your boundary. So what I mean is, if you'll talk about a particular example, then you can better understand this. And also, boundary informations are nothing but the flow variables that are known to us. And whatever the flow variables that are known, this basically you have to specify the input. And in worst case, you can reasonably approximate that conditions. And this is very, very important, this particular condition. And if poorly will define the boundary condition, then significantly you will get the poor result and your output also will be poor. Let us look at one scenario, that is cell zone. If you see this particular cell zone of a fluid, this is nothing but a group of cells for which all active equations are solved. So what I mean is, the fluid material which you are selecting having different conditions. For example, the mixture of the phases, how they are mixing, maybe the material which you are using, maybe the water, air or whatever, is having a porous zone, or maybe the laminar zone, or maybe the particular source condition, or maybe a fixed values, or maybe is having a radiation factor, or maybe independently you can see there is a rotation axis control wherever. So that particular specification, once you specify, then only you can go for that. So these are all optional inputs, like the porous source, laminar conditions, fixed and radiation, etc. But as far as the cell zones are concerned, you have to specify the multiphase flow characteristics, and you have to define clearly. Let us look at one example of porous zone here. So in case of porous zone, what happens is, this is basically a fluid zone, and this porous zone, what it does is, it identifies a particular zone where your particular material is porous in nature. That means it can penetrate inside, and just like it can soak inside. So this particular option, when you select, it enables the porous zone option inside your fluid, and also pressure loss in the flow because of this particular condition are trapped, and the resistance coefficient to the lumped parameter also are associated. And if you go for the model flow through the porous media and other type of distributed conditions, then you have to go for the packed beds, or maybe the filter papers, or maybe the perforated plates, or maybe the flow distributors or tube banks, etc. And inputs are directional, viscous, and inertia resistance coefficient also need to be defined. As you can see this here, the directions are shown here, and these are the constants and the relative velocity that you have to specify based on your particular mediums and direction. And another condition is cell zone of a solid. If you see this here, the cell zone that is of a solid, this is nothing but that is also again group of cells for which only heat conduction problem can be solved, and flow equations are not solved here. This is very important. So flow equations are not solved, only the conduction scenario is solved if you are going for a solid cell zone, and only the required input is the material. And once you specify the material, what happens is whatever the material you have, and under this you can specify the material property as well, and some optional inputs also are available, and that you can set for volumetric this heat generation rate or to designate the heat source. And also you can specify the rotation axis if required. Whichever the axis is there you can go for one, and can define motion for a solid zone also. When the solid is in motion, that also can scenario can be configured. So in our couple of examples, we'll be looking into that, but understanding the concept is very important. And let us look at one example, how you can locate the boundaries. So this is the flow scenario where you can see the number one here, the air is inlet, and at this particular place you can see the fuel is inlet, and this is basically the compressor valve, or you can say this location is nothing but the nozzle where the combustion is happening, and air and fuel mixture is burnt at this particular location when the combustion is happening and ingestion is happening. So three possible approaches in locating inlet boundaries for this example. Let us say the upstream of manifold. If you look at this particular condition, can use uniform profile or properly account for mixing and non-premixed mixed reaction model, and requests more cells. So you need to go for the clear meshing so that the number of cells will be required for understanding this intake condition can be taken care. And if you see the nozzle inlet plane, so where you are going for this inlet, computing that, so that particular plane you need to understand with respect to which plane this flow is occurring, and based on that you can directly compute it. So request accurate inlet profile. So you have to specify your inlet profile very carefully, and that can be taken care in modeling. And also the output, as you need to compute this output also is a reaction model. This is basically the output. So you have to go for the reactions and require accurate profiling here as well, and not generally recommended since inlet boundary conditions may drive their interior solutions. So in mostly if you fix or focus at the inlet condition, this is the inlet number one, the air, this one. And if you look at this particular condition, this is the inlet number two. So automatically this will be taken care, but primarily you have to focus at the accurate profile. So accurate profile is something where two different interactions is taken care. One is the correct modeling plus the right kind of meshing strategy. So when you combine these two, right kind of profiling can be taken care. And some general guidelines are there which can be handy. If possible, select the boundary locations and shape such that flow either goes in or out. So this is one of the very important characteristics. If you see back at this particular cross section, how the flows are like this, and maybe here based on the contour, how it is happening is primarily going like this. So if you look at this particular condition, not necessary, but will be typically observed better convergence. If you strategically specify your boundary location and shape such that the flow either goes in or out, flow goes in or out. So in that particular location, that can be handy in computing or solving that thing. So based on that, you can see the upper pressure boundary modified to ensure that flow always enters domain. So the output profile also accordingly controlled. So you need to be very careful in modeling your boundaries. Should not observe large gradients in direction normal to the boundaries. Indicate incorrect setup. If they are directly perpendicular to your boundaries, they cannot give the right kind of output. You can see this particular tone which is giving the wrong output, but here you can see how smoothly they are distributed, and based on that, that completely the modeling strategy is primarily the protocol which defines that. And in this particular location, you can see the wheel or kind of this will result. So in fact, you have to specify, you can split this and specifically specify this zone and go for a modeling and minimize mesh skewness. Skewness is something where this is the element, let us say, and because of larger skewness, that will be something more like this or more flattened to the ground. So this angle specifically is your skew angle. So if it is a rectangular element, you can keep more or less like this. So you have to avoid skew, otherwise it would introduce errors early in the calculations. So this is very important, and as far as your skewness are concerned, that can strategically be modeled and monitored during your meshing strategy, which I'll be discussing as well. And different available boundary conditions are available here. So external boundaries, internal boundaries, and some special conditions and sail zone also. In case of external boundaries, the pressure inlet, or you can say the pressure outlet, these are the general external boundaries. And for incompressible condition, the velocity inlet and outflow, the outlet we are not considering in most of the cases. The velocity inlet will be sufficient. In case of compressible, the mass flow inlet. These all boundary conditions you can specify, pressure, far field. And in other condition, wall, symmetricity, or with respect to axis, if your model is symmetric, then you can exploit periodic. Periodic is something, if something is similar to this, so once you investigate this particular area, so you no need to investigate this because there is a boundary symmetricity, so periodic in nature. With respect to axis, if your model is symmetric, then it's about an axis symmetric model, a pressure vessel kind of cases. And in case of special cases, inlet or outlet vent, intake or exhaust fan, etc. In case of internal boundaries, fan, interiors, porous, and radiators, wall, etc. conditions can be given input. And in case of sail zone, fluid zone or solid or porous medium can also be taken care. And in this particular example, you can see this particular profile which we are selecting is our inlet condition. Just like that, this highlighted red one is your outlet, and there is an orifice in between, and there is a wall here, and outer plate conditions which separates this and this. And next, we'll be looking at changing boundary condition types.